hit great God Almighty like an atom bomb when he comes, when he comes.
We present Dr. Strangelove, based on the novel by Peter George and dramatized for radio by Kerry Shale, starring Kerry Shale as Dr. Strangelove, Lieutenant Sweets Kivel, Lieutenant Barney Goldberg, Lieutenant Lothar Zogg, Group Captain Lionel Mandrake, General Jack D. Ripper, and President Merkin Muffley.
So I say, everybody's worried, yeah, about the atomic bomb. But nobody's worried,
no,
about the day my Lord will come, when he'll hit great God Almighty like an atom bomb. When he comes, good Lord, when he comes.
The time is precisely 6 megasnarfs in the third podmock. This is the Universal Broadcasting Corporation. And now, Tales from the Cosmic Void. Here are your friends, Poot, Fabelsnatter, and Zhlong Zhu.
Hello. I'm Put Hasnisnisnis Farblesnatter.
And I'm Zhlong Zuyip. Today's tale from the cosmic void is the first part of a very old and very sad story.
And do you know that although this is a make-believe story handed down through the ages, our records tell us that much of it may actually be true.
I didn't know that.
Well, I hope our listeners have more brain snobblies than you, Zhlong. Ready, everyone? Are you floating comfortably?
Then we'll begin.
I'll start, Zhlong.
Oh, very well, you start.
Once upon a time, long, long ago, on a faraway planet in a distant solar system, there lived 2 kingdoms. One was called Russia, the other was known as the USA, or America. This faraway planet went by the name of Earth. It was a small and pretty place while it existed.
Earthlings were a very mysterious race. Although they created beautiful art and lovely music, they also invented terrible weapons of destruction and death.
They were not one with the universal mind. They had no notion of wit, did they, Zhlong?
None at all. What? In fact, Russia and the USA had invented the same terrible weapon that could kill untold numbers of fellow Earthlings at a single stroke.
This weapon was commonly known as the atom bomb.
Or sometimes just the bomb.
Thank you, Zhlong.
Not at all.
However, towards the end of the 20th Earth century, the 2 kingdoms agreed to ban this bomb. Everyone looked forward to living happily ever after, now that the evil bomb had been destroyed.
Oh, but...
But what, Zhlong?
Tell about the secret bombs. Put.
Thank you, Zhlong. I was just coming to that. Certain people in the government of the USA were unhappy about losing their lovely bomb and secretly saved some old bombs without telling their fellow Earthlings.
Around this time, the people of the USA became very sad. Many lost their jobs. Prices rose.
Russia, on the other hand, somehow became a happy place to live. After years of poverty and suffering, the sunlight came out and the people became healthy and wealthy.
How do they do that? Sounds unlikely.
Remember, Zhlong, it's just a story.
Oh, yes, I forgot. Sorry.
Never mind, Zhlong. Tell about the leaders of the 2 kingdoms.
Well, the leader of Russia was a handsome man named Dmitry Kisov, who was much beloved of his people. In fact, he studied in the USA, receiving a degree in marketing and management from the Burger City University.
The leader of America at the beginning of their 21st century was an unfortunate Earth person known as President Merkin Muffley. It was shortly after his election that the American economy collapsed completely. This was known as the Second Great Depression because the people were so depressed.
Merkin Muffley! Ooh, what a pocky dotty name!
Thank you, Zhlong. I think we'd better begin our play. This is the story of how Earth ceased to be.
Merkin Muffley!
Zhlong.
Yes, Put.
Why don't you go soak your fable in a tub of cold donk?
Our play begins aboard a crewed United States flying vehicle known as a B-52 bomber. These huge planes had been retired in 1991, but because of the Second Great Depression, no replacement aircraft was ever commissioned. By late in Earth year 2003, the unfortunate President Merkin Muffley found himself lagging seriously behind in polls which canvass people's opinions. A gesture of strength was needed with which to divert the attention of the angry public. President Muffley ordered the huge fleet of ancient B-52s back into the skies, circling around their former adversary on a 24-hour alert. The polls showed that the Americans liked this sort of thing.
You want one of these here kosher dill pickles, Ace? Mighty tasty.
Nobody on board believed that the elderly bombs they carried would ever be dropped. The crew approached their tasks with a mixture of resignation and boredom. This B-52 is approaching its fail-safe point. Once it reaches this geographical position, it will turn and head back to America, to Burpleson Air Force Base. In the cockpit is the plane's commander, Major Noah W. Kahn, known to the rest of the crew as King. He is chatting to his co-pilot, Captain Ace Owens.
Dan, there ain't no better taste in the world than bologna and cheese with good old American mustard. Well, there may be one better taste, but I ain't gonna get any of that till I get back home. Now, where did I put my reading material? Ace, you seen my reading material? Ace, wake up, girl.
What?
Come on, you're still on duty.
Oh, no, King, I was just meditating. Here's your magazine.
You can't fool me, little lady. I seen you nod off during the second course. Back nabbit, Ace, even if you don't believe, it wouldn't hurt you to raise your voice to the Lord once in a while. Helps to clear the lungs. And I reckon your lungs could do with a little exercise if you catch my drift. And if you ever need any help exercising them big beauties.
Dream on, big guy. Dream on.
Yee-haw! Hey, Ace, take a gander at this. Speaking of lung power, woo, doggies. I wouldn't kick that little cowgirl out of my bunkhouse. Just look at them snakeskin boots, too. Almost as pretty as mine. And look at that. Would you just look at her juicy
King,
little...
King, I know you consider me just one of the boys, but in certain respects, I'm still my own woman. Now, why don't you just...
Major Kong, man!
What is it, Sweet?
3 minutes to turn point, dude. Fresh heading will be 353. Estimated arrival back at Burpleson is 2200 hours.
Yeah, roger. Sweet's heading 353 in 3 minutes. Come on, Ace. Now, what'd you say, huh? Ain't that just the juiciest little...
Major Kong, man!
What is it now, Sweets?
Hey, I scored a truly excellent batch of peanut butter cups just before takeoff. You want to try one?
No, thanks, Sweets.
Hey, man, good chocolate's getting scarce. How about a Mars bar, dude? Imported direct from England.
Forget it, Sweets. I got my own entertainment up here in the cockpit. Boy's got candy where his brain should be. Still, he's a darn fine navigator.
Hey, King. This one kind of reminds me of that brunette you had waving you off after the debriefing in Washington. She was secretary to some high flyer in the Pentagon. Oh, what the heck was her name?
Well, just hold up the photo, Ace. Give old King a good long look. Yee-haw! You're right, girl! You are right! Name of Mary Ellen.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Mary Ellen. You bent my ear about her for days.
Yeah. She was double grade A corn-fed premium, Ace.
Okay.
A beautiful example of the Lord's grace in action. Well, I'd ever tell you what she could do with
oh,
her
please,
lips.
Oh, please, King, don't get started. Just sit tight and study your picture book like a good boy.
Yeah, she was prime beef on the hoof, right off the top hindquarter, just the way I like it. In fact, she reminded me of you, Ace.
Oh, yeah?
Good lungs.
Oh, King, don't you ever think about anything else?
Well, this is the way it is, little missy. The good Lord gave me an extra special gift, if you catch my drift.
Sure, King. Your gift is pretty well known.
Well, all the ladies do seem to appreciate it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.